called Must the Communication Graph of NPC Protocols Be an Expander? And it's going to be given by I'm Too Cool to Wear a Name Tag.
Okay, thanks. So this talk is about secure multi-party computation. We have some parties, they want to compute something together. Now, we have many, many beautiful protocols from the 80s that show us how to do it. In the good old days, everybody talked to everybody. And when we have many parties, like today and nowadays, if everybody talks to everybody, there can be some bottleneck that can have some overhead. And one way to, do we really need this huge overhead? One way is to consider partial graphs of communication. So one way is to consider a fixed partial graph. Well, before we start computing, everybody knows who we can talk to. This is, again, an old model, it's well studied from the 80s, and corruptions on the net, on the of the parties can be a function of the topology in this case. As a result, we have many hard lower bounds. So even if we just want to broadcast a message, the connectivity must be T plus one, where it is number of corruptions. And if we have a linear number of corruptions, then the communication complexity is quadratic in the number of parties. A more recent partial graph methodology is a dynamic partial graph. Here, everybody can talk to everybody else, but they choose who to talk to dynamically during the protocol. And in this model, we can get around many of these lower bounds. So we can get secure computation where everybody talks only to polylog many other parties. We have broadcast where the communication complexity is linear up to polylog factors. So one interesting question is, when you look at the communication graph that you really get from these protocols, from secure computation or Byzantine agreement protocols, what are the necessary properties that you really need to get secure computation? In this work, we give a foundational study of the dynamic graph model, and we have a framework to analyze the various graph properties that we get from these protocols. And as an example, we look at one property of expansion. So all of the protocols that we know, both in secure computation and in the distributed computing, the underlying communication graph is an expander. And we want to see whether this is really inherent. Like everything in life, the answer is it depends. So we show that in many settings, we can have protocols that are secure, which are in a very, very strong sense not expanding. But for some functionalities in some settings, any secure protocol must be an expander. It's if you want to hear more, you have to be patient a few more days, and hopefully it will be on April soon. So thanks.